Welcome to our workshop on nurturing the faith of babies and toddlers in the nursery. We will be presenting two parts to this topic. The first session will explore the environment from a young child's point of view. In the second session, we'll discover the building blocks of developing a foundation for spiritual understanding in the nursery. Let's pray. Father, we welcome you into this time together, and we thank you for those that care about the youngest in our church family. We ask that you give us volunteers with caring hearts and that you give us wisdom as we reach your kids. In Jesus' name, amen. What comes to mind when you hear the word nursery? Wikipedia defines it as a place where nursing is carried on, or a room or area in a household set apart for children. Maybe it's a place where growth is promoted, but we know it can be so much more. Elmer Towns takes it to the next level, as he's often been quoted as saying, "The nursery is the handshake of the church." He goes on to tell a story of a church who hired a consultant to advise them on how to grow a healthy church. Upon the consultant's arrival for their first meeting, he asked the board to meet him in the parking lot, and he said to them, "Take me to the most important place in your church." The board hemmed and hawed, and they thought a while, and they came to the conclusion. Then they led him past the big, wide double doors into their sanctuary, up the platform stairs, and stood him behind the pulpit, facing where he could see the whole congregation. They all smiled, knowing they had picked just the right spot. He said, "Nope, take me to your nursery. It's the handshake of your church." Why would he want to start with the nursery? First of all, the nursery can be a warm welcome to a new young family in your church. Maybe these young people were raised in this church and they went away to start their careers. Or maybe they're a young family who never has attended church before, but now they begin to raise their little ones. They know they need the blessing of the Lord and the support of a church family. So like a handshake, a well-planned nursery with a friendly greeter, kind, consistent volunteers, provide a safe and engaging environment that begins to lay a foundation in a baby or young child's life and can gain their family's trust in the local church family, a place where real ministry can happen. Whoa, you say, maybe I just signed up for rocking and playing patty cake. What's all this talk about ministry? After all, they are just babies. Most of them can't even talk. What expectations can they possibly have? Well, I'm glad you asked. Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me." All of us want to be vehicles that take those children on their first steps to knowing Jesus. Have you ever thought about that picture where Jesus says these words to the disciples? Sure, we all have. But have you thought of them from the child's point of view? What they saw, what they heard, what they felt that day? Now let's make it personal for your church and the babies and young ones who come into your nursery. When a baby or a toddler comes into your nursery room, what do you think he or she wants to see? What could they possibly want to hear? And what do they want to feel? Let's take their perspective. What might a child ask for if they could tell you what they want? Number one, what will I see? A friendly greeter? A familiar face? Someone I recognize? Or am I going to be set down and have to wait around to be noticed? Oh, I know a good way to get noticed. A good loud scream will do the trick. Well, I see many things here. Well, there are going to be things for me to pull myself up on, to climb over, to crawl in and out of. Whew, will there be a place for me to rest? Is there space for me to crawl without being stepped on? Will I be able to walk without being knocked down? What can I see that they missed? What places can I reach, especially where the vacuum cleaner didn't clean, up or over? Are there interesting things to see on the walls at my eye level? Are there different places to be, like cribs, swings, bounce chairs, colorful blanket on the floor for me to stay? Will I have to stay in just one place for a long time, or may I move around freely when I want to? What about what will I hear? Will there be familiar music? My name being spoken? What is the tone of the people speaking? Is it mother ease? Did you know in sociology they talk about this language? It's a language you speak to young children. It's when your voice goes up an octave and you sound friendlier because you smile when you speak to them. Will people here talk to me and look at me when I talk or when I cry? Will they listen and respond to me? I like books. Will anyone read to me? Are there places to be quiet as well? Places to make fun, animal, or action noises? What about number three? What will I feel? Are there different textures to touch? Is the floor safe for me to explore? Are there pins or thumbtacks that I might put in my mouth? Did you know when I'm learning, I like to explore, I use my mouth. I like to get things into my mouth. Will I be able to get them out again? Will a grown-up make sure the toy I put in my mouth is clean before the next baby puts it in his mouth? Kids explore with their eyes, and then with their hands, and then with their mouths. Have you ever wondered why you know what everything tastes like? Dirt, metal, grass? Yep, you had it in your mouth at some point, probably when you were very young. Is everything I can reach larger than the center of a toilet paper roll? Because that's the level of safety we need in our nurseries. Do the toys offer lots of ways of exploring? What can I push and pull and stack and manipulate, collect, dump, throw over and over again? You know, I love repetition. Do I get to explore messy things like sand and water or dough? Do I have to wait to be changed or use the toilet? Is there only one changing table for everyone? Take a few minutes to get on your knees in your nursery. It'll help you see, hear, and feel what your children experience. Before you get up, while you're down on your knees, pray for the babies in your nursery and the toddlers in your community, for their families, and that the Lord will send you caring volunteers to create a place where ministry can really happen. As you do this, remind yourself that you're taking baby steps, welcoming children the way Jesus would. And when you welcome and care for the youngest of the flock that you're inviting into your nursery, you're sending a message to their parents and to really all the church family that they may also have found a faith family who will care for them. So welcome these babies as Jesus would. And the next session, let's explore together building a spiritual foundation of understanding in the nursery. Thank you, friends.